For nearly half a century, Charles Umlauf has created beautiful sculptures. Umlauf, whose work has been exhibited throughout the world, wants to leave his home and much of his art to the people of Texas as a museum. Umlauf's work appears in many public places, in Dallas, Houston, San Antonio, over the years, Umlauf's themes have varied greatly. The religious, and the romantic. The family. The expressionistic, and the abstract. Julius Umlauf was born in 1911, one of eight children in an impoverished immigrant family. He was 11 when he won a scholarship to the Chicago Art Institute. He continued to study into his 20s, surviving with scholarships and odd jobs. In 1937, he married Angeline Allen, a fellow art student. In the 30s, Umlauf was hired as an artist by the federal WPA. His first major commissions included work for the U.S. Postal Service. The bitterness of the Depression and the hardship of the war years are reflected in his early work, Refugees. Umlauf would obtain commissions for college campuses, office buildings, and churches across the country. And Umlauf's work has been purchased by major museums. His art is widely recognized. He has received grants from the Guggenheim and Ford Foundations and many awards. Much of Umlauf's work is in a sculpture garden right here in his own yard.
This is a marvelous house, mm-hmm. and the house lives with all the sculpture, but the garden also lives when you drive up your driveway. Mm-hmm. And this is an oasis in a very busy area now. I'm sure it was tranquil and serene and isolated when you first came here, but now you're right in the heart of the metropolis. But when you drive through that garden with all of those sculptures, peace immediately ascends over you.
This place of ours is a very special part of Charles' life and work. It is tremendously important to him and his family. We want to give it all, the house, studio, the gardens, and over 250 selected pieces of art to the people of Texas so it can be enjoyed as a museum for many, many years.
The casting process used in creating a major sculpture is elaborate and time-consuming. First, a model is constructed. and then shipped to Italy, where it is enlarged. The enlarged sculpture is covered with plaster, which hardens into the mold. The mold is separated and covered with beeswax, first as liquid, then as a heavier coat that has been mixed with resin. The thickness of the wax will be the thickness of the bronze. The wax-coated mold sections are assembled. The mold is turned upside down, and the center is filled with a mixture of plaster and brick dust called loto. When the loto is hardened, the mold is removed. Umlauf does the final retouching. Then the gates and vents are installed. The gates are the pipelines for the hot bronze. The vents exhaust the hot gases. Bronze nails are driven through the wax into the core to hold the mass in place when the wax is burned away. The outer investment is applied, then it is baked in an oven until the wax is consumed, leaving a cavity between the inner and outer loto, which will be filled by the bronze. The piece is lowered into a pit in the ground. Sand is tamped around it to hold it securely for the pouring. The molten bronze is poured. The investment is removed after the piece is dug from the pit. The now solid bronze gates and vents are removed and chased down. The figure sections are welded together. The Christ figure stands in the Texas Hill Country.
You came to Austin in 1940?
One, 41.
What was the then and what is now the artistic atmosphere of Austin?
I remember my stepmother saying before we came down here, excuse me, child, that we were fortunate it was Austin because that he was coming to join the faculty because the fine arts flourished here. Mm-hmm. They had guest artists in the music department at the university who were very fine and performers.
That's true. Yeah. One of the very good things about it was there were very few art departments in any university. Mm-hmm. They were. I think this was about the fourth or fifth. I don't know the exact count, but we were sort of a special outfit.
I remember the first time that I met Charles. He had come to the University of Texas from Chicago as a professor, and I don't believe that Charles had taught prior to this. So it was quite a challenge for him. And quite a change. And I came from a very small town to study art at the university. And I perhaps was slightly intimidated because the school itself was larger than my hometown. But I was fairly determined to learn because I realized I didn't know anything. And he was a natural teacher. And though he perhaps lacked, quote, teaching experience, he had beliefs and qualities and knew exactly what he was trying to get across to the student.
What I really liked about his teachings, Professor Umlauf's, I mean, what I liked about his way of teaching is that he taught us to be disciplined about sculpture.
In 1944, the Umlaufs moved to their present home on a hill overlooking Zilker Park. They had six children, four sons and twin daughters. Elder son Carl is also an artist.
The house, as I said, it was in a state of deterioration when we moved into it, but it quickly became very well refurbished and restored to its original existence, which was quite a beautiful old stone house. And the age of it, the age of the hill having been inhabited by Indians, the age of the house, the proximity of it to the park and to the city gave it a very unique position in our lives. The plants and the flora and fauna that my mother put in are all of her own doing. All the passageways were cleared by her and Dad, and sometimes the children would help. The large rocks were hauled in to make other walls and other stone dividers. The dirt was reshaped to create the uplift for the path itself, so that you could walk on it without sliding off. And because it was a very steep hill all the way around, it was like a fortress. And to make those passageways, those walkways, you had to really have a creative eye.
Austin Council Member Sally Shipman believes the gardens are special.
This is a lovely gift, a beautiful setting, and a real sense of place for our community. Everyone can enjoy this. Small children, elderly people. You can touch sculpture. You can feel it. You can feel man and nature, a part of a place, a beautiful place.
Tom Campbell is president of the Art League of Houston.
It's wonderful that we come here to this place to talk about Charles Umlauf, because here we're surrounded by Mr. Umlauf's work, and we're reminded on every hand why the Art League of Houston has chosen him as our Artist of the Year. You can't walk around this garden and not feel something very special in all the upturned faces of the various children, the religious figures, looking upward, representing man's search for something better, and at the same time, all the human figures. The wonderful, sumptuous, romantic things that he does, which celebrates life here on Earth, too.
Tom Campbell serves a committee begun by Roberta Crenshaw to raise an endowment to protect the Umlauf estate.
You know, there are a few cities in the world that have had the judgment to appreciate their artists while they were living and to guarantee the preservation of their wonderful work. There's a great tendency presently, I think, for people to become swept up in the commercialization, the opportunities to make money that exist around us, and it's a very easy time to forget the things that really will make the contribution to the quality of life in the future. This is one way, I feel, that we can at least do these things to our cultural enrichment that will inure to the enjoyment of all of Texas and all of the world. He is a man of renown worldwide. And it seems to me the logical, sensible thing to do, and something I feel like I must do, is to try to raise the endowment.
What does art mean to a community?
Yes, it just means to, it's the very spirit of humanity, because any case, any part of any civilization that amounted to anything had an art form, an expression, African, Chinese, anything you can see and look up their heritage, and there's always a belief in something. Mm-hmm. It was various kinds of beliefs, but nevertheless they believed and they expressed themselves through their art.
Mm-hmm. You know, art is for everyone. And public art is particularly for people of all ages and backgrounds and income levels, and especially those who may not have as much access to other forms of art. Umlauf sculptures can be enjoyed by anyone who looks at them. You don't need to have studied art to appreciate their beauty, to feel inspired by them. Sculpture likes to be outdoors in the sunlight and in nature. These gardens provide that setting. A leisurely atmosphere where anyone can spend some time and feel at home enjoying art. I believe that it is an important responsibility of the public to provide facilities like the Umlauf Gardens for its citizens.
Your own destiny. You know, and there's an old saying, I think Bordell said it, he said, your past guides you and your future follows you, and there's no better words to use.